welcome you to this, our spring program of the morning. It is my great privilege and honor to welcome our special guest performers who are joining us tonight in a performance of George Frederick Händel's Dixit, Dominus. Please give a round of applause for the Jubilate Orchestra and members of the San Francisco Girls Chorus under the direction of Dr. Ann Heggie. Our theme rather is inspired by the Dixit, Dominus. It's a virtuosic piece for chorus and orchestra, composed in Venice, finished up in Rome when Händel was only 22 years old. The text lends itself to something theatrical, both victorious and bellicose. It contains all the elements of Italian opera. The text of Psalm 109 is mysterious and at times puzzling, but was one of the most popular songs set in the 18th century by composers. And though we're not certain of the exact origin of the text, we believe it comes from the coronation ceremonies of Israelite kings. But we begin our program tonight with a piece by Estonian composer Velio Toivis, God Protect Us From War. Composed in 1984, the piece was composed as a protest to the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan. Estonians, Latvians, and Lithuanians, not yet having gained their independence from the Soviet Union, were fearful that they themselves would be sent to fight and die in a war they did not support. Behind me is a large town. It represents the sound of war. And as the war approaches, comes closer, so does the noise of the town. It crescendos and drowns out the voices of the chorus, until the voices triumphantly emerge again. We'll follow that with a second piece by Hungarian composer Zoltán Kodály, called Host. It begins with a singer standing amidst the crumbled ruins of the ancient city. And then they hear a voice from a ghost, and the ghost says to them, "Why are you standing here mourning for the past? What good will it do? Look rather to the future, move forward. Rebuild this place, and the homeland will rise again." Now, the castle of Hust is an actual place. It was built in the 11th century and withstood repeated invasions for over 500 years. The ruins today lie atop of a hill on the Tisa River of what was then Transylvania, and today just happens to lie inside the border of Ukraine. So it's fitting that the third piece is the Ukrainian national anthem. When you hear the musical introduction from the organ, we invite all of you who are able to stand for the other.
Thank you.
games and illusions, and all there to put a smile on our face and help us escape the cares of daily life. The next piece, Varushka, or the threat, is by fellow Czech composer Leo Szabaczek. It's dedicated to Dvorak, and here he demonstrates what he learned from the master, that is, how to set a folk song and turn it into a great piece of music. Here in the threat, the male chorus sings the part of the lover who has been cheated on, but rather than grieving over the loss, decides to exact a kind of revenge by falling in love with another, and seemingly takes great delight in showing just how happy they can be with someone else. You can think of Rushna as a Czech version of Murray Gator's I Will Survive. A final piece is a new commission by Bay Area composer Steve May. The text and melody are taken from an old hymn in the Ozark. And tonight, we're very happy, after a two-year delay, to finally get the world premiere of Steve's rousing and inspirational composition, Neufheim.
Thank you. This night my soul has caught new fire. Halle, hallelujah. I feel that heaven's drawing nigh. Glory, hallelujah. I long to drop in this conqueror's clay. Halle, hallelujah. And shout with saints in endless day, glory, hallelujah.
Heaven is
And his name, oh, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
There's not one, there's not two. There's 9 books of Italian madrigals by Claudio Monteverdi. And each book is a mini-series, and each madrigal is an episode, or better yet described as a telenovela. Because scenes are filled with high drama, they're overt emotions all centered around love. And in the Lamento della Ninfa, the nymph has been abandoned by her lover. She's pleading for him to come back. And the male chorus behind her is in fact us, the audience, watching in fascination as the miniseries unfolds. Our soloist for this evening's performance will be Isabel Yang. But first, another Italian madrigal by the German composer Heinrich Schütz. Yes, Monteverdi was well known throughout Europe, and composers from all over wanted to imitate the master Monteverdi and write their own take on Italian madrigals. So here is Alma Afflitta by Heinrich Schütz.
Thank you.
of someone overcome with sadness by being separated from the one they love. The forests, the meadows, the songs of the birds are all reminders of the emptiness they feel in the absence of the lover. But magic suddenly takes place in the forest, and the natural world is transformed into, well, a psychedelic dream, in which the singer starts seeing nature in vivid colors and goes on her own magical mystery tour. There is a moment of intense excitement when the singer sees the reappearance of the lover. Dance with me, take my hand, wrap your arms around me, embrace me, kiss me. And in that kiss, the lover starts to slowly vanish and leaves the singer to tearfully say farewell and good night. Our last piece of this set is an Irish folk song. It's the last rose of summer, and it is a love song for those who have gone on before us and for all of us.
Thank you.
Oh, con prego.